Next up is a tool which is what we call as the Wayback Machine. So it is basically a tool which is used to show how your website used to look like 3 years from now, 5 years from now, and so on. So basically, you can try to find out how your website looked like, what were the various tools you had used to create that website, and now what is the difference between your current version of the website and the previous version of the website. So it will help the attackers also to find a lot of information as how your website used to look like, what were the technologies used at that time, and what are the technologies being used right now. Hello viewers, welcome back. So as explained in the previous video, that there exists a mechanism by which we can in fact go back in time and check how a particular website used to look like. For example, if you're having a website right now and you're managing that website from a very long time, for approximately 6 to 7 years, and you would like to see how you have evolved since these last 6 to 7 years. So you can simply go to this website called as archive.org/web, and you will have a simple looking search box over here. What you need to do is you simply need to type in your website's URL and press browse history. But before that, let me first of all tell you what this website is all about. This website is basically a non-profit digital library of all the internet websites. Obviously, it will not have all the internet websites. It might have few websites not listed in its particular database. It is quite possible. For example, there might be few websites which are not yet crawled by the search engines. Those websites will not be available over here. But those are exceptions. Apart from them, all other major websites, or even some not so popular websites but still which have been crawled or indexed by the search engines, all those websites will be available over here. So if you would like to see how your website used to look like back in time and how it actually differs from what it looks currently, so you will be able to see what were the various technologies used at that time and what are the advancements that you have made to your website over the last couple of years. So you can do that with the help of this website. Even if you want to download some static copy of your website, so this can even be used to recover, or you can say recreate, some look and feel of your website. For example, nowadays even Google is going retro at times. So you can say that if you want to go back in time and copy the look and feel of how your website used to look like, you can do so with the help of this tool called internetarchive.org. So you can simply go over there in the search box and type in your website's URL, for example, facebook.com, and press browse history. You will come to know when and where Facebook was actually launched. As you can see over here, the graph is actually beginning from 2004, but you can see that more number of hits or more number of traffic is generated around 2005-2006, and again the popularity goes down. And you can see that after 2007 or 2008, it is again growing in popularity, and right now it is at its peak. Fine. So you can click on 2005, for example, and hover your mouse above the calendar. As you can see, this calendar view maps the number of times Facebook.com was crawled by Wayback Machine, not how many times the site was actually updated. You can say that these many times this particular website was crawled by this particular archive.org crawler, but it is not indicative of how many times Facebook.com was actually updated. So you can see so many blips over here. It doesn't mean that these many times Facebook was updated. It simply means that these many times Facebook.com was crawled by archive.org. So let me click on this 27th November, and these many times on 27th November itself, you can see 8 snapshots. 8 times the website was crawled by archive.org. So let me click on any one of these versions. It will take some time to open up, and you will be able to see how actually Facebook.com used to look like. So this is how Facebook.com actually looked like in 27th November 2005. If I move over here using these arrows, I will be able to switch between years, and I will be able to see now on 28th November 2005, this is how it looked. If I click on 28th November 2006, I will be able to see how it actually looked like in 2006, and this is how it actually looked like. Slight difference, but still you can see these two buttons are added over here. Let me go 1 year more in future. Future as in from 2006 I'm going to 2007, that's why future, right? So now I'm moving from 2006 to 2007, and now you can see there's a considerable change in terms of the look and feel, but still it is not what it looks right now. So let me click on 2008 and see how much of transition happened between 2007 and 2008. After around 2010, 2012, Facebook actually started changing its look and feel altogether. So that's why I have taken Facebook as an example to demonstrate how things actually worked out for them, how they actually gained in popularity in the 2010s, 2015s. So this is how we are used to look at Facebook. So this is how the homepage transitioned from 2007 to 2008. There was a huge change in terms of the look and feel of Facebook. This is what I am used to, because when I had created my first account, I guess this is how Facebook used to look like that time. Nowadays it is totally different, right? So now let me jump to 2009 quickly and show you how Facebook looked like in 2008 and how it differed in 2009. So almost similar, just few additions in the footer section. As you can see, something added in the footer. So this is how it keeps on changing, and finally you will be able to see that in 2020 or in 2021 it will be a huge difference in terms of how it actually used to look like at that time and how it looks like right now. So you can see that this is how it used to look like in 2010. And if I open Facebook.com right now, this is how Facebook.com looks like. Isn't it totally different? Yes, it is totally different. And that is how websites actually transition. So we are actually lucky that we have examples such as Facebook.com, Google.com, using which we can actually differentiate between how they used to look like 10 years, 20 years down the line from now and how they actually look like right now. This is a very interesting tool, and you can even use it to recreate your existing look and feel of the website, to go retro and try to copy how your website actually looked like 10 years back from now. So stay tuned for the upcoming videos. The next video is going to be a video on a tool called as Nikto. So stay tuned and learn what exactly Nikto is and how we can make use of that tool Nikto to protect our computer systems. So stay tuned.